In this video, we are going to discuss about GE8161 Problem Solving and Python Programming Laboratory, 13th exercise, that is the last exercise, Simulate Bouncing Ball Using Pygame. Okay, so first bouncing ball la enna paakala. So bouncing ball, it is an interesting subject of analysis demonstrating several interesting dynamic principles which is related to acceleration, momentum and energy. Almost everybody at some point in their lives have bounced a rubber ball against a wall or floor and observed its motion. Normally, we don't think about the physics of bouncing ball too much as it is fairly obvious what is happening. The ball basically rebounds off a surface at a speed proportional to how fast it is thrown. But what is not known to most is what is specifically happening to the ball before, during and after its brief impact with the surface. To begin this explanation, let's first consider what happens to a typical rubber ball that is dropped vertically onto a flat horizontal surface and which falls under the influence of gravity. In this explanation, the bouncing ball will be broken down into several stages in which the ball motion before, during and after impact is analyzed. To simplify the discussion, let us assume the bounce surface is hard, that is rigid, and that air resistance is negligible. The first stage, the ball falls vertically downward under the influence of gravity. Then the acceleration and the velocity will be moving downwards. The magnitude will be the absence of the air resistance. It is the first stage, and the second stage, the ball begins to make contact with the surface. It continues to the fall vertically downward under the influence of gravity. The third stage, the ball has slowed down. The velocity is still pointing downward. However, the ball has deformed sufficiently such that the acceleration is now pointing upward. This means the ball has deformed enough such that it's pushing against the surface with the force greater than its own weight. As a result, the acceleration is pointing upward. In the fourth stage, the ball has reached its maximum deformation. As a result, the acceleration is still pointing upward and the velocity is zero. This means it is at lowest point. The fifth stage, the ball velocity is increasing and pointing upward since the ball is now in the rebounding stage. As a result, the ball is less deformed than in the previous stage but is still deformed enough such that it is pushing against the surface with the force greater than its own weight. It means the acceleration is still pointing upward. The sixth stage, the ball is barely touching the surface. The velocity is still pointing upward since the ball is still in rebounding stage. However, since the ball is no longer deformed, it has essentially zero contact force with the surface. It means that only force acting on the ball is gravity. As a result, the acceleration is now pointing downward and the upward velocity is now decreasing. And finally, the bouncing ball can now become particularly interesting for certain cases. That means the type of balls such as super balls can give a backspin, and after the bounce, the velocity and rotation of the ball will reverse direction. Okay, so the bouncing balls na enna engiradha paathom. Next enna paaka porom appadina pygame appadina enna nu paaka porom. So it's a Python pygame. It is a game development library. So Python is the most popular programming language, or nothing wrong to say that it is next generation programming language. In every emerging field in computer science, Python makes its presence actively. Python has vast libraries for various fields such as machine learning, artificial intelligence and game development, that is known as Pygame. To replace PySDL, Pygame is written. So the Pygame is a cross-platform set of Python modules designed for writing video games. It includes computer graphics and sound libraries designed to be used with Python programming language. It uses simple direct media player library and several other popular libraries to abstract the most common functions, making writing these programs a more task. Pygame is suitable to create client-side applications that can be potentially wrapped in standalone executable. So bouncing ball using Pygame enna paathom. So adhe dhaan nama manual link kuduthirukku, how to write a Python program to simulate bouncing ball using Pygame. So adha algorithm kuduthirukku, then program and adoda output. So eppadi indha ball bounce aagi up and down poyittu varudhu ngiradha paakaporam. okay so ipo python program eppadi run pananu nu paakrom so c portable python la py scripter open pandren so py scripter open aayirchi idla na coding type panni vechirken so now I am giving run illana control f9 kudukalam namak run aagum सो पारेंगे बाउंसिंग बॉल इप्डी बॉल अप एंड डाउन पेट वरदंगर तेरी दा एंड इट्स योर आउटपुट सो आधे दा नम्बरडा मैनुअल लिंग कुड़तरकु इधे आउटपुट निंगे कोड़ा वच्ची क्रॉस चेक पनाला सी इट इज़ द मैनुअल आउटपुट and it's a real output see ball bounce aagi up and down namak paitu varudhu okay okay so it's our last exercise that is the 13th exercise in GE8161 problem solving and python programming laboratory and we have simulated the bouncing ball using python I hope you have understood thank you